And this is the LCDR on channel 1, checking all stations are manned and systems ready. CLCDR?
Ready.
Talker?
Ready.
Timer?
Ready.
QAM 1?
Ready.
QAM 2?
Ready.
QAM 3?
Ready.
FSC?
Ready.
Prop 1?
Ready.
Prop 2?
Ready.
PTO?
Ready.
ACC?
Ready.
LWO?
Ready.
AFLC?
Ready.
Launch Vehicle Director?
Ready.
This is the LCDR. I'll be conducting my briefing at this time. Current status of the pad prep are complete for weather status. We're looking at a less than 10% chance of constraint. We have no colas at this time. And are there any questions?
Launch day is the culmination of 2 or 3 years, 4 or 5 on some missions of work that's gone into this final day of loading up this launch vehicle and putting this spacecraft up into orbit. So it's kind of like your wedding day. You build up to it, and here it is, and it's today. And it's a very serious day, and it'll impact that mission from here on out because you're sending it on its way.
When I come in for launch day or launch night in the firing room, and I come in, I can see a frenzy of people going around. I'm like, oh, it's going to be one of those nights. So that's one end. The other side is if it's quiet and the weather's good and people seem to be just kind of just now ramping up, ready for a good count, it's nice to be able to ease into it and hopefully prepare for a somewhat relaxing countdown.
To proceed at the end of this built-in hold. NLM.
Stand by.
DE.
This is the NLM with our ready to proceed with terminal count at T-minus 20 minutes. NASA CE.
NASA CE is go.
SMM.
NASA MM is go.
SMA.
SMA is go.
NAM.
NASA advisor team is ready.
SMD, are you ready to proceed?
SMD is ready.
Copy that. NASA team is ready to proceed at T-minus 20.
We have up roughly 7 or 8 channels on at one time. So the one thing that the launch managers are very good at is filtering out conversations. We're able to sit there and absorb about 7 or 8 channels and even be talking at the same time while we're listening to some of the stuff going on in the background.
The winds, if we get them, will actually come out of the direction to move those storms. Will be out of the southeast.
Go ahead, MOD.
And like I said, I just want to let you know, we still might have a third or not in range on the anomaly channels. The way they're coming, it looks like they're going to be.
Can you imagine? It's like 7 or 8 different conversations, all on a different topic possibly. And you're trying to pull this all together and make sure that everybody's talking about the right things at the right time to make sure that we're able to grasp that right recipe to be able to launch that day.
SMD, this is the NLM on the NLMnet.
Go ahead, NLM.
Yes, sir. On your problem with communicating with AstroTech, are you guys working black phones or is that comlink back up?
We're working black phones and still don't have the VOCA and comlink up.
Copy that. Will that be a workaround into the launch off, or is that not acceptable?
That's listed as a mandatory, so it won't be acceptable.
Copy that.
NLM MD on 8.
Go ahead, MD.
Yeah, I just wanted to confirm. I thought I heard you talking to the spacecraft. The comm problem between AstroTech and here is workable.
Currently, that's a mandatory for them. They're working it on black phones, but they'd like to have...
Even though we practice and simulate problems prior to launches in dress rehearsals, you can't always predict what problem is going to present itself on launch day.
NLM, this is SMD on NLMNet.
Go ahead, SMD.
We do have a PCC issue on our power control console.
Is that going to be a problem?
Still assessing.
Copy that.
We track along with it and we make sure that the engineers are following their process and they report out on the anomaly resolution, as we call it, and hopefully they give us a ready to proceed, and then we pull the management team and get concurrence from there.
SMD on NLMNet.
Go ahead, SMD.
Yeah, getting back to you, we have no further issues. We resolved the PCC issue.
Copy that.
Working relationship that Chuck and I have stems back from roughly 13, 14 years. We're very comfortable with each other. So it's wonderful that we have a great working relationship. We enjoy each other's professionalism and vice versa when I do the role as the ALM, the assistant launch manager. On his missions, we're doing the same thing. If we're getting too busy, like I said, there's times when I have seven comnets going at once. I can't talk on all seven of them at once and keep the conversations going, so I might be off working one issue on one net, and he's off either telling him to stand by, he's working an issue, or he's off working it himself for me.
Yeah, NLM copies and concurs with that, NST.
Okay, we've still got DFC working on the specific limits and the recommendations.
NLM, MDNA.
If they're less conservative than that, I don't
This is ALM, go ahead, sir.
Yeah, I just wanted to let you know the range receive and record capability in Antigua's okay. Back end, where the range is green at this point, so I know of two issues at this moment. That's the spacecraft communication with Astrotech and then the potential weather issue.
Yeah, and we can confirm Astrotech voice is back up.
Oh, Astrotech is back up?
Correct.
Roger, then we're only working the...
I try to give Omar as much support as I would want myself. I want him to be as successful as he can be. There's kind of a lot of unwritten things that we do for each other that we probably is just a reflex.
T-minus 4 minutes and counting.
What could still go wrong after T-minus 4? Everything. That poll is a poll to make sure that everybody's mind is set and we're ready to launch. But we could have hardware go bad. We could have the weather go bad. We could have a lightning strike that catches us by surprise.
T-minus 3 minutes. OSM.
T-minus 3 minutes and counting is not the point of no return. It is a point where we're getting much closer, and blood pressure is rising, it's an exciting time because, again, we've gotten through a lot, a big part of the countdown, and we're getting really close.
This is the NLM on the NLM net for our ready to proceed with terminal count and final launch poll. Currently working no issues on the range, launch vehicle, or spacecraft. At this point, I'd like to poll the team for... concurrence to go or no-go. NASA CE.
NASA CE's go.
NASA MIM.
NASA MIM is go.
SMA.
SMA is go.
SMD.
Minus 2 minutes.
SMD is go.
NAM.
NASA advisor team is ready.
Copy that.
Pressurized.
NASA team's ready to proceed into terminal count and final launch readiness.
T-minus 110 seconds.
Prop 2. Top first.
MD NLM on mission management.
Copy 100%.
Go ahead.
Sir, NASA is go for launch.
Roger that. Copy. NASA is go for launch. LVD, this is the MDN-8.
LD.
Yeah, permission to launch.
Copy, permission to launch. T-minus 90 seconds.
SSC, hydraulic external power on.
External. Hydraulics go.
T-minus 80 seconds.
RCO, report range go for launch.
Range is go.
LCDR, you are go for launch.
Roger.
T-minus 70 seconds.
SSC, hydraulics internal.
Internal.
T-minus 60 seconds.
LCDR.
The last 60 seconds for me are very exciting. A big part of my job has been completed. It's still quite nerve-wracking. You know, the pressure is up, the stress level is up. But, you know, with the launches I've done and the rehearsals and stuff, I feel confident that I'll be able to do that.
Main power disabled on.
On T-minus 35 seconds.
Hydraulic scope.
T-minus 30 seconds. T-minus 22 seconds. T-minus 20 seconds. T-minus 15 seconds. Copy, go.
Green board.
T-minus 10, 9, 8,
Niner's arm.
7, 6,
water go.
5, 4,
engine
3,
start.
2, 1, 0.
Lift off.
Plus 1, plus 2.
Working with the LSP team is something that's phenomenal. It's a disciplined program in the sense that there's a structure to everything we do. It is great work for engineers. It's satisfying.